Thank you, Chairman. Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, in the past, if you go to big companies like Philips, Shell, and many others all over Europe, you could find that people got a job there or at the end of the year, celebrated for 40 years service in the company. 50 years, 30 years. It was a time that when I was professor at various universities in Europe, that before the student finished the studies, that he already got a job. Today, what is the situation in Europe? Not only Europe, but in many other countries in the world, that is that the student is studied up to 25 years old, and he was then hoping, after all these efforts, to get a good job. Now, what is the practical situation? It becomes for these students, after a PhD or an MSc, that they don't have difficulty to find a job. Second one is they have to wait very long before they get a job, and then not a job that they wanted or for what they have studied, with salaries which are much lower. And some of those, we got a job, and 15 years later, as we now have the cases in a number of companies, for example, a chemical company in Germany, an important one, in which I'm involved, they are 40 years old, 45, 50 years, PhDs in all kinds of topics, particularly in chemistry, and they have to leave the company. It's very difficult. At 50 years, we give an early retirement. At 40 and 45, it becomes a little bit difficult. The situation where we are today. At the European Union and the European Parliament in Brussels, we are really very concerned. And also the parents, also the associations, also the community, the society becomes very worried with this situation. And the reason is that for the time being, their students are studying up to 25 and later up to 30 years for medical doctors, and they don't have the job or difficulties to find the job they want. On the other side, you have the industry, and the industry has many vacancies available and don't find the people. A Google in Geneva in October, they only could find 30% of the people they wanted to have. Now, there is something wrong with the education, particularly at the universities. And we call it in Europe the crisis at the university. And there is a real crisis. Yesterday, I still had a talk also with the director of the university, and she also confirms the same kind of situation. So, this is a problem. Now, we have to think that in the future, we are entering the fourth industrial revolution. That means cancer will be solved. Climate change will be solved. We have the car without drivers, no traffic jams. I can go on. The fourth industrial revolution, we need a number of people. The innovations and the discoveries have to come from universities. But the university cannot, the present university, cannot deliver these people. We have to change the university system. Now, what is the problem at the university? Well, the problem is there mainly that they train students for a specific job. They put PhD in physics for a physics job and PhD in chemistry for a chemical job. But the society is not interested in these disciplinary jobs. The society wants to have that the problems we have in the society are changed. Like we could put climate change, that you finish your study, that you're ready to participate to solve really problems which we have in the society. That means in order to do that, to solve a problem in energy, you must have the capabilities for a multidisciplinary, I call it transdisciplinary education. So over education, what we have now as the vertical education, the education between not contacts with others at the universities because there are very big walls between an institute and another. We have to find ways how to provide a multidisciplinary, a transdisciplinary education to these students, so that these students can solve problems which they don't know during their study time. Problems which have to be solved, that they get with a budget, in a limited budget and time, that they can solve it. And not that they are starting like 50 years ago to get the training at the company and that they can nicely integrate. They have start from the beginning. Now, in any case, in order to do that, we have to change the university, and what has to be changed is we have to get and to come to a multidisciplinary. That means that today already in Brussels at the European educational systems, the European rectors, we say today and advise to students, it is better to have two MSc degrees than one doctor's degree. That is already an advice which we give today. Now, in future, we need to have a multidisciplinary. That means the following. We cannot accept today that a medical doctor, a specialist in specific fields, is putting implants, knee, hips, and the motor, put implants, and that 25% of the implants are wrongly placed. We are now at the European Union establish rules in such a way that we give guidelines to the hospitals in Europe, to the so-called Association for Medical Doctors, to say that not every doctor or every specialist in orthopedy or in another field or cardiology it can really do what he wants. That will be put under restrictions. It is not allowed that 25% of the treatments, what you get are wrong. And that is not only in the medical doctor, that is in many fields. So we have to give another education to all the branches we have today. In order to do that, we have then to try to set up multi-transdisciplinary faculties at the university. I cannot go already in all these details because there is no time available. I have a report of 150 pages. I have only 12 minutes in order to read all those pages. But the point is here that, for instance, a faculty in medicine will be transformed in a medical, in a faculty of medicine, engineering together with other faculties, without neglecting the topics of ethics, without forgetting the topics which are related to human relations, to philosophy, etc. But education, which is in any case very broad and very specialized at the same time, to be a specialist in physics, chemistry, at the same time. And the point is here that yesterday the rector said, in its speech, if you do that in multidisciplinarity, then you cannot give the education what is needed. It is not going into depth. I disagree completely. We will give in future an excellent education in various disciplines and at the same time to be very qualified. It is not for everybody who will be able to study each of those. You have a number of these problems. Now, we have set up in Europe a group of experts within the framework of European Union, the same as with the Americans, the same as Japan and China. With those four, we have the academies, we have the European Rectors Meeting, we have a number of bodies, and we are now setting up these new structures for the university. Like I said, it is for the time being still difficult to say. Our main problems are the professors. They are absolutely incapable to teach the multidisciplinary topics. There are still many professors in Europe who only teach the same course for 30 years. The problem is also here about the so-called, we have to be worldwide. Therefore, that is all the worldwide nations are already taking part, more or less four advanced nations and the best universities. The problem is that at some universities who are excellent in Europe and are on the best ranking, like Caltech in the United States, MIT in the United States. If you look about Tokyo University, if you look about the best schools, they already have done it and doing it. If you look about MIT, the medical and engineering are already close together. In many universities, we don't have. Now, the point is that we train a student not only for a region, like we do it now, like here in Serbia, there is money for the universities coming from Serbian government, and all in all places, it is very local. We have to get worldwide. The people should be trained, multidisciplinary, and at the same time for worldwide jobs. I will stop here, but that is the way to go. And we have problems, number one, with the universities. We have much too bureaucratic, and we have second point, the problem is we don't have the right professors. And what do we have to do? We are now in a number of universities in Europe, we try to get out of the professors at 55 years old, and what are we doing with those who are 40 and 45, and they are not capable for the job? Thank you for your attention and a few words.